And look at what our goal is now. So we've gone, we've had him spin, he's now locked in on target, now he's going to bring his gun up. So what's happening? It's going to be slow motion. He's going to bring his gun up, cock it, and then it's going to start spinning like a Gatling gun, and then as I'm zooming in with the camera, and then a bullet is going to go flying out of there. And so we're just going to get the basic motions. I won't start with the camera spinning. That's kind of a cleanup work that you kind of add in a little bit later, and the bullet itself will add maybe later, certainly in another tutorial. It won't be in today. This one's going to be a long one. Alright, so how do we do that? Well, first off, pose to pose animation. Let's get him into his starting pose, and then we'll get him into his ending pose. Okay, and then we'll talk about a tween, a pose in between. Alright, so his starting pose, let's get it to about where we want it to be. Now here it's more important because we're seeing more of his body. So I wish I could describe to you better what I got going through my mind. I mean, I've got a pretty vivid image in my mind, and you know, certainly if you were to go to my Facebook page, you could look at some of the artwork that I did back for comics, and certainly I could draw him in a good position that would be very explanatory, but it takes a while. And since I got a strong image in my mind, now it's just a matter of getting it out to you guys. And I think the best way to do that right now is to just get going. So he's going to be kind of leaning back a little bit. Alright, let's just kind of get him ready to go. And now he's got to be prepared, so we're cocking him around a little bit. Alright, let's move that one a little bit more. Alright, and now, like I said, we're going to be getting some more of his actual arm in there, his big monster arm thing. Okay, so that's going to be cocking, so you know, his chest is going to be nice and back, and I really should animate that other arm. Now this other arm is basically, I wish I would have just, I don't know, done something different with it. I mean, it's just a placeholder. I mean, really, it does nothing. He never uses it, and as we're going to see in my little film, eventually it's just going to get him into trouble. It's going to be a liability more than anything, and that's all it's been as I'm animating too. But anyway, so let's just get him into a good, strong, now pose to pose animation. It's all about finding that key pose that just tells the story. Everything you want to tell all at once. Trying to lock it down into one awesome pose. Okay? Alright, so maybe his fingers will be, maybe he'll have like a little bit of fist action going on, and I don't even know how much of this you're going to see, actually. I mean, you'll see most of his body, but I can't tell you that you're going to see all of it. Alright, now let's look at it from the side. Now you're going to be looking at it kind of from this angle, and I'm going to hide that, H key. And I'm going to hide that one too, H key. Alright, so you're going to be looking at it from this side. And now the idea is he's going to be bringing that thing up and cocking it. So I'll go with this pose as it is right now. And I might have to tweak it some later. So I'm just going to insert it there. Okay. And now how long do I want this shot to last? I don't know. Let's just start off with 2 seconds. And I can obviously retime later. So that'd be 50 frames forward. Something like that. Alright, and now let's get him into his final position. He's brought his body is now forward. Boom. That might be a little bit too far, I don't know. Alright, he's bringing it forward. Boom. He's bringing his whole body into it. In fact, he's probably going to have to take a step. Alright, so this is okay. Okay, so before I had... I'm going to select... So I don't lose all of this. I'm going to select everything and I'm going to press Control-C. Now I've got that thing copied into my buffer. And so now, notice I haven't inserted any keyframes. So now as soon as I move my timer, I'm going to lose this pose. But I didn't lose the pose because I copied it. Now I can paste it. Control-V, and I've got it back. I haven't inserted anything. So that's just kind of a safety measure. All right, but let's look. So I'm thinking I'm going to have to make him take a step between now and then. He's going to have to step forward, and that's fine. So this foot is going to have to stay stationary. When you step, one foot always has to stay on the ground. All right, let's go back 50 frames forward, But now this foot is going to move forward. So let's get that where you'd want it to be. Bam, something like that, maybe. Okay. Now he's like so. Let's rotate that. Bam, something like that. Bam, all right, I didn't go far enough. Something like that. Now this one's going to have to rotate though. Okay, how is that looking? Yeah, that's okay, I guess. I'll live with it. A little bit of leg cock. Okay, there, there. And it's just a matter of tweaking it where you want it to be. And now, I've never been one to, you know, I really should do some more elaborate inging, you know, to get some shapes and stuff in there, but I just have never, you know, I'm lazy. I mean, it'd be really cool, but I don't know. I'm sorry. It'd be really cool. And when eventually I do load this stuff up to BlendSwap, if somebody wants to go around and rig it really well and do some tweaking on it, I would love you. And I probably wouldn't kiss you because 95% of all Blender users are male, but you know, I'd certainly be all right with that. Okay, how do I like that? Now, if he is, so he is now cocked. Do I like that one? No. If you could see me, I'd be like making a pose right now. All right, and I'm trying to think. Okay. So it would be kind of just the opposite. He'd be more like this. That shoulder, the leading shoulder would be more kind of up. His shoulders like cocked back a little bit. Get that where you want it to be. Get his face at the right angle. By right angle, I mean we're looking on. Okay. Alright, now he's got to be ready to let that cannon fly, and so I got to move his hand out of the way, his palm, so I'm assuming it's going to shoot from this barrel. Okay. I could probably get by with doing something. I mean, it might be kind of cool. I wonder if it would shoot. Nope, I put the finger right over it. Oh, that's perfect. I was thinking on that one, huh? I was thinking it would be kind of cool if I could have the bullet go right. Maybe I can. Could, like, if I were to have this one be the shooter, right there, shoot, go right through his fingers. That'd be kind of swell. That'd be kind of a cool effect, don't you think? I think. So he's ready to shoot. All right, let's take a look here. Is that going to work? Maybe. Yeah, I think we can make that work. So he's going to shoot right through his fingers. Alright, now how's that pose look? I'd probably cock that arm a little bit more. I mean, even if it is just a placeholder, it still looks kind of, it looks cooler if you... Now eventually I'm going to have to move those flanges, obviously. Alright. Looks like he's ready to shoot. I'm going to insert that pose. Alright, and so now you will notice a lot of things happen. Now, even just looking at that, I mean, that's not awful. Okay, it needs a lot of work. Now we just look at, we want a tween motion. Alright, so the first thing that's going to happen is he's going to kind of explode off that back foot. And so I'm going to take that back foot and I'm going to have it hang in position for a little while. So his body is going to start to move before his back foot moves. So I'm going to move that forward, I don't know, a few frames. Bam! So he starts moving with the body. And now what did I say in the last lesson? That typically the face leads? It works. Hey, you know, I'm liking this. I really am. All right. So let's see what we got going on now. Okay, let's turn off my storyboard. All right, we got shbam. Okay, now let's see. So his body leads a little bit, and I could probably even. All right, let's exaggerate that. So his body goes even forward. I mean, usually that's how you work. You like press off, and we'll see how. Bam. So let's have him press off up too. Nah, that's no good. Okay. And now I don't think I'm going to be seeing his feet in this shot. And so I'm not going to animate them any further. I mean, normally you'd want to have some kind of like, you know, that sort of thing where he's like stepping off the ground and it looks really nice, but since I really only think I'm going to be catching about this much of him, I'm not going to worry about it. Okay, and now it's just a matter of getting that where he's thrusting forward. Okay, and he's cocking too. So let's have him like, he brings that arm up, like cocks it up. And let's have him hold it a little bit. All right, so I'm gonna insert those two. So notice how, and then I'm gonna grab that keyframe right there and I'm gonna stretch it out. And I really should give you more room to look at that, okay? He cocks it, bam, and then he extends. Cock, and in fact, let's have this kind of thing happen. So let's have it like, he cocks it. He grabs it up really tight. Shoot. Okay, now the problem is I've got this discontinuity right here. Let's Oh, something's going on. It must be in this. Okay, yeah. Something's up here. So this is what I'm gonna do. Is that what's going on? There's a little bit of a jump, like a. So which one is it? Select them both. Here, let's just even out the frames and let's see if that helps. Maybe if I were to move this one back a little bit. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy that position and I'm gonna move it there. All right. Now you notice this line here? That means that these two keyframes are the same. So the position of his forearm at this frame is the same as the position at that frame. Okay? And so what I want to do is I want to change that. But as he's rotating, that upper arm is actually swinging back. And then he brings it forward. Okay. All right. I'm okay with the overall motion.